I'm going to show you how to add protection to your Roku remote. What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. Hey, I've got this Roku remote. This actually goes to the Hisense TV, which I just picked up, which I really love. This is the same remote that you would get for a lot of Rokus. It's the enhanced remote. It has the TV controls right there because it's CE-SEEK enabled. And as you can see here, the button layout for this particular remote. Now, there's a few different layouts, and so you want to get the right cover if you're going to protect it. And that's what I got right here. Hopefully, I got the right thing. So we will find out because this is a true unboxing. Now, first of all, this is a two-pack, and I was really excited about that because that's a really good value. A lot of these remote covers are like $6, $7, $8 for a single one, but this one has two, and you can get it in black and an additional color. So I got it, I guess this is yellow. I think they had it in green and orange, some of those things, but I didn't want the black. I wanted the green. Now they're are exactly the same, so I'm just going to show you this one because I think it's a little brighter. And really, one of the reasons that I want this is that invariably you will drop the remote. You know, it hits the floor, kind of freaks you out. Sometimes the battery compartment opens up. You don't want to break it. Sometimes you get the little rattles inside the remotes. That's always annoying. So one, it should protect it. But then secondly, when I use a bright color like this, it's also going to help me find it in the dark when you're watching that scary movie and you need to pause right before the lady takes it to the chest with the butcher knife. You don't want to have nightmares later, you know, so you got to have that remote really handy. So this will help, you know, keep it visible, and you should be able to find it in low light because this is pretty bright. You can see here we have a little bit of a diamond pattern on the back that should help give it a little bit of grip. I think this is a silicone cover. It's pretty squishy, as you might be able to see here. We have cutouts here for the TV control buttons. We have a cutout right here for the infrared blaster. We also have a couple little holes right here because, as you might have seen, this comes with a little lanyard. So I think that's a little funny for TV remotes. It's probably nice to hang it up, but this is like a lanyard that you would have on a GoPro or something like that because you can cinch it down so it won't come off your wrist even if you are letting go of the device. But I don't know, I guess that's kind of nice, you know, especially if you really don't want to let go of it. And then you can see we have a really big cutout, and that should line up with the buttons that sit down as far as about 3/4 of the way down. So I'm just going to push it in like this and then just pull this up, dresser, like I used to do with my dolls. And as you can see, all the buttons are easily accessible. It's very thin, so you don't have to worry about kind of a big lip there. You can see here the buttons for the side. Volume rocker is easy to get to, and the infrared blaster is very visible too. I'm not going to put in that lanyard right there, but you can see here, now I've got a ton of grip. There's actually a little bit of a recess right here. I think that's like a finger groove, and it's actually molded into the silicone right there too, so you still retain that. But as you can see, it's just a really easy, cheap way to do it. Now, if you have a lot of Rokus, I love the Roku streaming TV box. They are my absolute favorite. I love the Roku TVs. The TCLs make them, Hisenses make them. And so this is a great way to get two of these for both remotes and add a little protection, make it a little visible, and, you know, prevent yourself from having those nightmares because you can't pause the horror movie in time. Do not let that happen, please. Hey, if you want to pick these up, I'll put a link to them in the description. Peter Von Panda, out.